The programmed cell death protein 1, or PD-1, found on the surface of T cells is critical for immune cell-cell signaling. When PD-1 expressing cells bind to cells that express the PD-1 ligand proteins, such as PD-L1 or PD-L2, it protects them from being killed. In other words, the binding of PD-1 to PD-L1 sends a don't kill me message to T cells. This immune suppression mechanism prevents autoimmune damage. Usually, T cells can kill the potentially cancerous cells that pop up in our bodies every day. However, some cancer cells express PD-L1 or PD-L2 on their surface, survive immune T cell surveillance, and may grow into life-threatening tumors. In this video, we will use information stored in the Protein Data Bank, or PDB, and tools available from the RCSB Protein Data Bank to understand the molecular details of how antibody binding can prevent PD-1 from binding to PD-L1 and restore T-cell surveillance. Say you were reading a scientific article about Pembrolizumab, an anti-PD-1 antibody approved by the US FDA for treating various cancers. And you note the PDB identifier 5JXE for the structure of the human PD-1 Pembrolizumab Fab complex. Begin exploring this structure by going to the rcsb.org homepage, typing the PDB identifier or PDB ID 5JXE into the top search box and clicking on the search icon. The structure summary page for PDB ID 5JXE shows a snapshot of the extracellular domain of PD-1 bound to the antigen binding fragment or Fab region of the pembrolizumab antibody. Besides listing the structure title, the author names, this header section shows a validation slider providing an assessment of structure quality. As you scroll down, the literature section provides information about and links to the publication describing this structure. The macromolecules section provides detailed information about each of the protein chains present in this PDB structure, that is the PD-1 protein fragment and the heavy and light chains of the pembrolizumab Fab. More details follow concerning the structure determination, structure publication, and revision history. On the top of the structure summary page, a series of tabs present different types of information about the structure. Clicking on the 3D view tab allows interactive visualization of the 3D structure using Molestar Molecular Graphics Viewer. Clicking on the Annotations tab provides information integrated from various structure and function classification resources, and in this case, information from immunoglobulin databases. The Experiment tab lists crystallization, data collection, and refinement details. The Sequence tab maps important structural and bioinformatic features of each protein in this structure onto their respective polymer sequences. To examine these structures and integrated information interactively, open the 1D 3D view. If you click on a residue or a polymer segment associated with a specific feature in the 1D panel, the 3D panel highlights and focuses on the same residue or polymer region. For example, to examine the specific residues of the PD-1 protein that bind to the antibody, click on one of the purple highlighted residues, specifically a serine, to see its various non-covalent interactions with the antibody proteins. The genome tab shows where the protein gene maps on the genome, while the versions tab lists the revision history of the structure. This section of the video focuses on understanding how pembrolizumab prevents the binding of PD-1 to PD-L1 during cancer treatment. We will begin by searching for a structure of PD-1 bound to PD-L1. The rcsb.org website offers many query options in the top search bar and in the advanced query builder. A simple way to find PDB structures would be to search using the UniProt accession code for this protein, in the top search bar. Scroll through the results returned and read the titles of the structures. To find the first structure of human PD-1 and PD-L1 in the PDB, you can sort the results by oldest to newest release date. The PDB structure 4ZQK has the human PD-1 bound to the human PD-L1 domain. Let's use the rcsb.org pairwise structure alignment tool to compare the two structures of PD-1, one bound to PD-L1 and the other bound to pembrolizumab. Click on the Analyze menu at the top of the page to open the tool. Type in the PDB IDs 4ZQK and 5JXE and select the chain IDs corresponding to PD-1. Run the tool using default options. The tool shows a good alignment of the PD-1 chains in these structures. The root mean square deviation of around 1 angstrom suggests that the PD-1 protein chains in these structures are nearly identical. Now, after the alignment, choose the structures from the Select View options. The matched parts of the chains are colored darker than the unmatched parts. The gray protein chains corresponding to the pembrolizumab bound structure occur in two groups. We will hide one set of chains for clarity. To do this, open the Molestar options, select the chains distant from the superposed PD-1 chain, and then hide them. In a stylized representation, we see the two proteins PD-1 and PD-L1 as oval shapes. The pembrolizumab Fab domain occupies the same region of space as part of the PD-L1 sphere. Thus, the binding of pembrolizumab prevents the cancer cell from sending the "don't kill me" signal to T cells, making it more likely that the T cells will recognize the cancer cell as a clear and present danger and proceed with tumor cell killing. Did you know that the US FDA has approved other anti-PD-1 antibodies for cancer therapy? We can use some simple rcsb.org tools to find structures of PD-1 bound to these antibodies and examine how they work. Let's go back to the structure summary page for the PDB ID 5JXE. In addition to presenting details about the structure, this page provides simplified options to search for PDB entries with similar sequences, 3D shapes, the same UniProt identifiers, and more. Click on this button to find other PDB structures that contain a protein with the same amino acid sequence as human PD-1 in this structure. The rcsb.org group summary page shows 8 structures in this group. Besides pembrolizumab, there are PD-1 structures bound to nivolumab, tislelizumab, and dostarlimab. Let's note their PDB IDs. Using the rcsb.org structure alignment tool, you can superpose the PD-1 structures from each of these complexes bound to the respective antibody Fabs. By displaying the structures view, as we did in the previous video segment, you will see that each antibody binds to PD-1 in a slightly different location and interferes with PD-L1 binding. While nivolumab, pembrolizumab, and dostarlimab have been approved by the US FDA as effective anti-cancer agents, tislelizumab is approved for cancer therapy in limited locations.